For centuries, we've relied on maps as a way to navigate our world, and more recently, we've become highly dependent on GPS to help drive our cars and navigate treacherous waters. What if those maps and GPS satellites were suddenly unavailable, or even worse, intentionally changed to provide erroneous information? Welcome to another episode of Cautionary Tales from the Dark Side, where we delve into some infamous case files and see just what lessons they have to teach us. In today's tale, we'll be exploring a vulnerability found in the internet equivalent of GPS, domain name services. This is Codename Nautilus. Domain Name Service, or DNS as it's known, is a common internet service that allows us to use recognizable and memorable domain names instead of cryptic numeric IP addresses to locate and validate websites, email addresses, and many other resources. DNS has been around since the very early days of the internet and lies at the heart of modern networks everywhere. However, like most technologies of the early internet, it was never designed to accommodate the scale we face today. And unfortunately, any disruption can cause enormous ramifications. In 2008, security researcher Dan Kaminsky was, as he puts it, playing around with DNS when he stumbled upon something unsettling. DNS servers work by forming a sort of hierarchy network among themselves. If your local DNS doesn't know the address of a given domain name, it will consult the next DNS server up in the hierarchy until a so-called authoritative DNS response is found for that domain name. Now, to make things more efficient, your local DNS will hold that authoritative response in memory for a period of time, called caching. Kaminsky had figured out a way to trick most DNS servers into remembering responses that did not come from the authoritative DNS for a given domain. Using this vulnerability, someone could redirect traffic destined to a legitimate domain to some alternative location, stealing information and identities in the process, all without the victim being any the wiser. Kaminsky knew the seriousness of what he had just uncovered and called an urgent meeting of DNS vendor representatives to share his findings. Kaminsky publicly announced his findings on the same day that most DNS vendors released fixes for this vulnerability, urging organizations who have DNS servers to apply the upgrades. He had intended to give everyone 30 days to address the issue, but details of the exploit had been leaked after only 13 days, leaving any unpatched servers vulnerable. These kinds of attacks don't necessarily trigger all the warning bells in your monitoring system, so it's hard to know just what impact there might have been. But do know that almost every organization was and still is vulnerable to DNS-based attacks. The Global DNS Threat Report for 2020 estimates organizations are exposed to 9 various DNS-based attacks per year. When DNS outages take place, applications can quickly fail. With the average time to mitigate a DNS attack being over 5 hours, that's a long time for an outage. Financial losses can easily run into the millions of dollars, not to mention the reputational damage. In some cases, businesses have suffered permanent damage and have been forced to close. So how can we defend ourselves against DNS attacks? First, through regular patching. Critical security patches are vital for any system, including DNS servers. Those organizations which quickly heeded the warning by Kaminsky to patch their DNS servers were in considerably better position for doing so. A regular patching process is a good first line of defense. You might also consider migrating your DNS servers to a cloud-based solution like AWS Route 53 or Azure DNS, where patching is done automatically. Second, we can harden our DNS servers. Hardening is a process of updating configuration and tightening controls on the server to make it more secure and more resistant to unauthorized access. DNS was never designed to withstand the kind of attacks we see in the 21st century. So spending extra time securing our DNS servers have helped avoid many vulnerabilities. Next, we can audit our DNS zones. Zones are collections of DNS records, and for those zones that we're responsible for, it makes sense to keep them tidy and up to date. We can also consider adopting DNSSEC. DNSSEC is an additional layer of security on top of traditional DNS lookups that allows us to validate responses we get from other DNS servers as truly authentic using cryptographic signatures. Not every DNS provider supports DNSSEC, but if yours does, it might be worth a look. Finally, be open to cooperation with other organizations in the event of a DNS exploit. Because DNS attacks can have far-reaching implications beyond our own sphere of control, cooperation and information sharing often help accelerate resolution. Although DNS has been around since 1984, it's still a favorite attack vector because of its ubiquity and relative simplicity. Even after all these years, many consider DNS as the Achilles heel of the internet.
I'm Scott Pletcher, and this has been
Cautionary Tales from the Dark Side.
For more cautionary tales, consider subscribing, notifications, or just a thumbs up. Leave a comment to report other cases we should investigate. The people deserve to know.